faster he spins, spinning, when you make the pipe, the greater it has to spin. The faster he spins, the better the pipe gets. And the similarity is the karmics, all kind of different karma coming together very fast to perform the next level. Next one is the conscience. That one is the conscience. The conscience is a picture is Buddha go like a monkey. Monkey has special reaction. He's agitated. He's jumping one brain to another brain. And also his future coming is defending his position. In his position, he's likely to jump towards you. Therefore, the consciousness is defending the laying back a little bit in the part of it. But what the karma is feeling when he goes towards that situation. Therefore, like a monkey, out of the karma because of the monkey.
第三呢，就所谓的我们的心，我们的心是，就把它化成是猴子，意思说呢，我们就好像是一个好像猴子一样，起伏不定，蹦蹦跳跳，就是我们的心，因为受到这个烦恼所，这个困住，因此呢，我们心呢，到处种种不同的这种业，也因为心烦恼不断的上升，下降升起，增长或者是不停的上下甩，使到呢，当我们表示说我们。
一个人的造恶业的三业呢，他都会随着这个业力的烦恼和妄，就是说，其他的所谓的三业呢，往生这个三业道中，恶业呢就往，这个三个道中。And the consciousness is like a thought, it's like a thing, that consciousness needs something to live on. This is the name, next one is the name and form. The form is five aggregates. Now we start studying the form. Five aggregates are like the standard of the form, and then so on.
So if we understand the form, is normally we will know. 就是所谓的我们由这种无明，无明呢的产生开始呢，产生这个种种的这种烦恶，所以从这无明产生种种烦恶以后呢，我们就因为，就是所谓的我们在这个十二因缘里面，就是由这个十二因缘里面呢，由这个所谓的无明形式。
The standard of form, the standard of feeling, standard of cognition, standard of emotion, and the standard of consciousness. And these are the names. And then the name, the name and the form. This picture is like a board on the waters, because the name and form is necessary. The boat needs the waters and the captains and the ruling and all those things. Now the consciousness is putting together necessary things to take again forward to bigger levels to experience the deeper karmic experience.
So, from the beginning, 然后通过这个我们的心识、产生这种名色，这是什么色身这样的会，然后借助这个六度，因为我们这五蕴，有这五蕴以后，我们就接受外面的东西，到处的种种的这种障碍，开始无常。
And it is the main form, now the consciousness is entering the mother one. other feelings, all the things that come in next level, the six sources.
在十二因缘里面呢，第一个是无明、行、识、名、色、六入、住、受。当我们有这些的时候呢，我们看到、我们摸到、触受、我们有苦乐的这种时候，以后我们就是爱，爱，然后我们制造就起，然后跟这种就是有以后呢，我们就会生，生的话就是我们投入母胎。
The six sources or the six senses, eyes, ears, nose, tongue, body, mind. And then when they form, the Buddha will draw the pictures like house. But the perfect house, but inside is owner is good, but not good, no occupants. But these six sources now need control. Therefore, these six sources give a support to follow. From the six sources, go forward. Before the six sources, laying the support from the enormous. And now it is going forward with the one to another, one to another.
So, in the teaching,
由这些慢慢的，在这个轮回中的变动是已经过起来，第一又从第三第一，这受想行识，这六六六六，所以啊，这个东西呢，我慢慢的就会因为这些各方面呢，我慢慢的执着。嗯，这是我们在，在这个故事中的pictures。There's many things of contact. Like here, the Buddha told that, many of the human contact. Touching hand each other. When you touch something, then you get feelings. That's because when you touch, you feel. Then the touching is not stopped, but the touching is meant to go to the feeling.
So, this is the so called touch. Touch is just to touch. When you touch something, then you get feelings. That's because when you touch, you feel. Then the touching is meant to go to the feeling. So, this is the so called
touch. And the next one is the feelings. Is Buddha wrote that shooting the eye, the arrow in the eyes, a very experience of feeling strong. Because if you shoot the arrow in some places, it's suffering, but it's suffering. If you shoot it in the eyes, well, it's so intense. Therefore, the feelings, the pleasure or the unpleasure thing, you cannot stop. Just the feelings is must go harder.
Craving, that's the other.
Craving, that's what the things are like, things that we crave in forever. No, they are not only the feeling, but craving.
So, this is so called the
爱东西的业主的话，我们因为这个问题呢，等于这个问题呢在追求。嗯，as well like this, when you go to shop, we see something nice, we cannot wait to touch it. That's why the Buddha said, please don't touch. No, and therefore, when we touch it, then you get attached to it. Oh, nice. And then after that, craving. I have to have it. And then after this comes up, you come to the root of samsara.
所以，这是为什么我们当我们看见东西的时候，喜欢的时候，当我们喜欢的时候，我们想东西触摸，当我们触摸它的时候，我们想说，我想拥有这东西。所以，就那种开始，所谓的触受爱起。
And the next one is the craving, or taking. Craving is like a monkey's picking up the food. so much crap to the monkey because they are like one taker, even they look for the next one. Then sometimes have trees, they have to grow the next one, the next one. Sometimes just keep growing and always keep jumping. That's why they jump with everything. We buy so much things and we don't use the puzzle, we buy with the next one. Then we have a grass set. No? And then all these things, that's what the things are doing, things the teachers are, what are we going to call the truth? We really have to think deeply what we're going to cut. What we have to pay attention. These are the important things to cut it off. And then the next one is the existence. The existence is the pregnant woman is going to give birth. Is this this ignorance that all this full support now is coming into existence?
所以当从开始呢，从这个时候的无名行识、名声入住受爱其有这些记住以后的因缘记住以后呢，那么我们开始呢，就是我们的心中有一种形象出现。
And then the next one is the giving birth. The picture is giving birth, then it's giving birth, and then all this, sickness, death. And these are the repeating that over and over, this four number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, again and again, small.
So when they were born, this was the image, born, this image was born after, there was born, there was born. So when they started, from born, old, sick, and sick, and this kind of thing, the image is still there.
And as a practitioner, we must pay attention to this. Should I still has to continue? Should I suffer myself? Should I get rid of my ignorance, desire, attachment? Should I let it go? Especially today, joy means letting go. Let it cut off all the feelings, no? Because that's what the thing is. Contact, feeling, calling, taking. These are the, our really descriptions of our happiness. No, if you don't have this, you have a very relaxed mind, you have peace of mind, you have experience big and positive. And everything will make you find success.
So, this is why we become a meditation. 所以从我们的所谓无名、行识、名色、六度、触、所爱、其、有、生、死、老、死，这所谓的流转的十二因缘，使到我们不断的在回痛如苦那个，不断的在流转。
And I saw something in India that I never forget. I was too hard because in India, in Dehradun, I went to do something that is a village that's very narrow street. Not for the car, just when there hardly people can pass, now very near. And one day I went there, there's a Kuvik Samsara. There's somebody died, and they bring in the dead body. And here somebody got married, the boat has to go. And they very much touched each other. And then it looked like that the Parsami Kaza said, enjoy the Samsara. And the other one said, please come back. Goodbye. It's just like what the samsara is, you know? There's so much of these, so much illusion. And that's what makes us suffer.
So I saw a very interesting. 所以这种强烈对比呢， 就是我们他说他看觉得非常的一种感觉，说一个呢是已经很完满，在这个人生已经走完他的人生，一个呢正在开始了要走他的人生，所以这种强烈对比的这种很使到他非常的震撼心灵。
The instant barrage, the general flow, the compassion for all sentient beings.
So, we can have a switch of the instant barrage, the instant barrage.
And this instant barrage to change and do something good for everyone. Good for yourself and good for all sentient beings. When at the time of death, you will be happy, you will be at a liberation, and all your followers of family or whatever is experience positive. Therefore, very important to generate your kindness and
compassion.
And today we have what we discuss about. Now we're going to cover all these problems in 2 hours.
所以今天呢，我们这十乘法，十乘法主要呢是把这所有的所谓十二种念呢，都把它真正的断掉。
But anyway, today I'm going to do the truth healing ceremony. It was I'm going to do 3 times. Part is called nectar offerings. They were composed by the Lord Jiva Sumo. Lord Jiva Sumo is the founder of the Kirti lineage.And then he was also prophesied by Buddhas in the one of the sutra called Great Clouds. And he, in there, Buddha gave a prophecy that says in Tibet, known as the Snowman from India, they are going to be named called Rana Shiri. When these persons came to take a birth in this place, and then my teachings will be flourished again and beautiful all sentient beings.And then also another is a sutra called the Wisdom of Sutra. And it is also mentioned, it says here, the Buddha, that snow mountain area, they are going to be great Bodhisattva will take a birth. And it is the Rinchen Pal who is going to liberate all sentient beings.
So, today,第一个部分呢是所谓的甘露的供养，或者叫甘露供养。这个师生法呢是有这个教诲，就是这种感觉的一个宗教教诲，既然说不能说犯罪的一个师生法。所以建树公呢是动感情的这个创始人，所以他是被所有的这个诸佛呢所预言，所以在这个佛陀曾经预言呢，在西藏的某个地方呢。有个名叫这个大气神，将会出现一次，他的出现呢，他使到我的教法再次的弘扬，你的所有的这个西藏，所有的这个西藏。同时，另外这个经典也强调了，在有个山上附近的有个地方，有个人，这有这个大菩萨呢，将专制于当地，他的名字叫做明清霸，同时。他的初心呢，也将利所无量，还有广度无量无边的这个众生，这两些都是在经典或者在这个佛所预言的这个所谓的再来。
Also there is Padmasambhava's life story. Also, I give a prophecy. He says, from the sunniest, not far from the sunniest, could be born. There's Great Bodhisattva will take a word called the Rana Shiri, and there he is carrying the teachings of the Mahayana and Vajrayana and flourish all over and benefit the sentient beings.
So, in the Lianshi, he also has a meeting in the Sanyasana region, there is a Buddha named Bao Qixiang, who has appeared once.即使呢，他将会大把所有的这个佛陀的这个大乘的教法、金刚乘的教法，把它流传于这个世上啊。
The next one is the healing ceremony. It was also written by the Raga Isis. I'm going to do this healing ceremony. And the first part is you visualize yourself as a battery winner. But sometimes when we do the church, we have to lie down and things like that. That's what, like the cemetery. You go to the cemetery, then you lie down. No, but some teachers do, some teachers just sit. Today, we're going to sit up and meditate. And you visualize yourself as a battery winner. And then when I say pet, when your consciousness comes out of the central channels, and becomes the Vajra Yogini above you. And then all your aggregates, the standards that we talk about earlier, what the negatives and all these things, transforms into the Nectra. And then you become your own consciousness of Vajra Yogini. Now you liberate sentient beings. As you apply your offer to the Buddhas and the Bodhisattvas and the Edom, the Dharma protectors, then you offer to the God from the lower realms, the hell realms essentially. They will be liberated. Animals, animals, humans, Vimika, Ratrams, all will be liberated. Whatever the karma will be wonder. We're talking about not only this life, many lifetimes. We may be animals, we may be the humans, we may be all different things that we have a karma. Now we will be liberated. That's why the giving the ransom to all the spirits and the ascension beings.
我们的所谓的供养，这个诸佛菩萨不是所谓的佛法，是还有我们三根本，上是本尊，中是护法，还有所有一切六道的这个众生，就是上至天道，上至这个天道，这个修罗人道，第一恶鬼畜生。 所以六道的所有一切众生，同时呢，还有以所谓的我们多生多世这个眼睛在处，就是我们的身体作为种种的甘露，满足所有的上至的诸佛菩萨，还有下至的六道的所有一切众生呢，都得到满足，而且因为得到我们的这个甘露的供养，使到了他们都可以所谓的解脱。
And before they become the Vajra Yogini, there's the auspiration prayer. They say, all Mother Sentient Beings now expanded is the sky. And what they mean is, where the sky, there's the sentient beings. There's the sentient beings, there's a completely other aspirations, emotional sufferings. Therefore, in order to make them happy, make them free from sufferings, lead them to the liberations, I'm going to do something special today. Today's special is I'm giving my Vajra body for the benefit of all sentient beings. Just like a Buddha. Buddha gave his body to Tibet because out of war, out of compassion, Buddha cannot see sentient beings suffer. Therefore, now today, as a Mahayana follower, we are very fortunate. We come to the understanding that each and every sentient being is connected. Therefore, today I am happy to receive this precious human body, and I'm able to enter into the Buddha Dharma Sangha's teaching, and I realize kindness. Now I'm paying kindness and compassion, repaying kindness and compassion. Therefore, may all Mother sentient beings come here. Your son or the daughters is paying the price.
So, we have to do this. 做这个种种的烦恼。 到他们的地址，到时候就有受苦的痛苦。今天呢，或者有的是这个为了满足解脱他们呢，所以就上那种以我的那个金刚身的这个化身，就种种的甘露呢，来满足解脱他们。所以就好像这个所谓的这个佛陀的舍身念佛一样，以这种来。为了所有这个众生，贡献自己的这种身体，把这身体布施出去。所以我们今天身为这个大乘弟子，也请也把这个我们的身体呢，化为种种的甘露呢，来供养我们诸佛菩萨，还有六道众众生，特别是我们多生多世的眼睛开。所以我们今天呢，召集他们过来呢，来这里呢，聚在这里呢，把我们的身体呢，来布施给他们。
And when we lay the trumpet and then I meditate that he was the special announcer, because when like a king or somebody give a special practice generosity or gift, and they announce for everyone to come and gather and get. And therefore this trumpet is announced that we make these nectar offerings to that for all the sentient beings, that those who have a form, those who don't have a form, visible or invisible, all these things please gather to accept this offering. And then when you blow it, you meditate that all the existence of the top of the samsara to the body, they hear this and then they come.
Thank you.
有病痛的，我有什么病痛，我们可以观想，都被这个石子吸，都浸在这个石子里面。
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Maraguya, Pacha, Maru, Yono, Motivo, Mm-hmm. Yeah.